President Marcos orders the Foreign Affairs Department to ensure the safety of Filipino workers in Taiwan. This comes after China's envoy to the Philippines, Wang Shilian, said Filipinos in the self-ruled island may be put in danger amid increased U.S. military presence in the Philippines. But the DFA reiterates Filipinos in Taipei are safe.
He has given the general order na always watch out for the safety and welfare of all of the blues, including in Taiwan. And we wish to assure our senators at the entire public na may contingency plan. Matagal na to. It's a thick book, no?
More witnesses come forward with several accounts of alleged political killings in Negros Oriental. Jasmine Romero is on the line with that story. Jasmine?
Denise, just like yesterday, witnesses continue to surface in today's hearing by the Senate Committee on Public Order and Dangerous Drugs in connection with alleged unresolved killings in Negros Oriental. Well, one of those witnesses is Juanita Generoso, widow of radio broadcaster Dindo Generoso, killed in 2019 for allegedly commenting about issues on dump site in Negros Oriental. Generoso said her husband were good friends with Henry and Arnie Tevez. But in the presentation by Pamplona Mayor Janice Degamo, she alleges that the killers of Generoso were rewarded by former Negros Oriental Governor Henry Tevez with contracts and job opportunities. Tevez denied giving the suspected Generoso killers the better treatment despite being involved in the Generoso killings, since some of the contracts procured by them are not signed by Tevez but by his LGU administrator. And he believes that one of the suspects looks different from what the evidence showed. Mayor Janice, on the other hand, indicated that before his death, Governor Roel Degamo reached out to the Senate and other government agencies warning about the situation in Negros Oriental, but was ignored until his death. She even expressed her regrets that had the agencies acted quickly, the governor would probably still be alive today. More witnesses are still testifying at the moment, and it is expected that this will continue on to tomorrow's hearing. Denise?
Thanks, Jasmine. The Philippine government prepares for the repatriation of Filipinos in crisis-hit Sudan. Foreign Affairs Undersecretary Eduardo De Vega said they're in talks with foreign groups to assist Filipinos. He adds the efforts are made difficult with operations in Sudan's airport also affected.
Yung ating embada, nananalagan sila sa mga Pilipino, tawagin sila palagi para, yun nga, para mapalita kung anong kalagayan nila, para sineset up ng embassy ngayon yung mga rescue missions. So, about 258, no? Pero yun lang ang alam namin registered. Baka mas marami pa. Alam namin, mga 178 na yung kumontak sa embassy, tapos at least 60 yung gusto nang umuwi.
A Filipino living in Sudan's capital has appealed for immediate repatriation, saying they fear for their lives.
Pagka po may bombang sumasabog, pakiramdam po namin nayayanig din po itong building na tinitirahan namin. Kaya yun po yung kinakatakot namin. Doon po is ninervyos na kami dahil nag-iisip kami na papaano pa kung itong building na tinitirahan namin ay malagpakan po ng bomba at magkamali ng hulog.
The Philippine Health Department advises the public to refrain from engaging in recreational and occupational activities in areas of Puerto Galera affected by the oil spill. That's after some water samples in the island destination were found to contain oil and grease contaminants. Health officer in charge, Maria Rosario Vergeres, says only 9 out of 35 stations tested passed the Environment Department's water standards.
Tayo ay nakapagpalabas na po ng joint statement with the Department of Environment and Natural Resources kung saan inaabisuhan po ng Department of Health based on safety and health measures to refrain from occupational and recreational activities dito po sa mga katubigan na nakitaan natin na bagsak dun sa mga test. So ito po ay isang abiso na binibigay natin dahil this might cause harmful effects to your body.
Meanwhile, tourists have continued to cancel their bookings in Puerto Galera after water samples there tested positive for oil. Local officials estimate the tourism industry will lose around 5.5 million pesos daily if the cancellations continue.